I'm gonna try doing this. I'm gonna be trying to talk to you about this vacuum here. The RICCAR commercial vacuum. If you are considering getting a business or like a household business or just vacuuming in general, and you are looking for a professional vacuum for anywhere really, I'd pretty much highly recommend this vacuum. It has withheld a lot of stuff. This is not your basic vacuum. This is a professional grade commercial use vacuum. It is extremely rugged. It's meant to take a pounding, and that I have done to multiple vacuums like these. Now, the reason I say most of this is because I work for a school district, and even though we have, where is that? I don't think there's a vacuum in here for that. Well, anyways, they call it a Ghostbuster vacuum because it's a backpack and you put it on your back, obviously. But I prefer using this upright RICCAR vacuum. I believe this one might be the first generation of its kind. I can't really say that because I've never seen anything other than this. But, yeah. It's a lifetime belt, which, if used correctly, it can be. Used incorrectly, more than likely not. This one here was bought from Vacuum Center, apparently. I don't know if they're still in business, but this is the sticker that is currently on here. Now, you'll have to bear with me here because I want to talk about some stuff, and the phone is not gonna be very stable here, but anyways, if you're new to this vacuum, on, off, power button. If it's on, it turns green. If you have issues with suction, this is where it's gonna turn red. More times than not, if something gets stuck, it's gonna start from in here. This is removable. Well, it is removable. Take that up, remove that hose. This comes off of here, and you can do that. So if you have to, you bend it just right, you can see through that. If something's not stuck there, you can take this off and look through there, and you can also undo this. Now this can lift up, and chances are if you can't find anything along in here, there's two more spots to look underneath the vacuum itself where the brush is at and clogging there. And or do they have something too big and it's stuck right in here? Chances are, if you fill this vacuum up and this doesn't light up, you might have to actually change your bag. The bag. Now, the first time I used this, I was trying to pull this. I was trying to do absolutely everything I could for roughly 10 minutes trying to figure out how to open this, when all you have to do is you press down on this black knob and you open it. Voila. Now, this bag, it's not always the easiest to get on, and I'm not going to take it off for that fact that I'm holding the phone and I don't want to do two things at once. But it does hold a lot. And unless you personally poke a hole into this, damn it, I didn't want to do that. Unless you purposely yourself do something to make this vacuum not work, that bag will stay on there. Now, right here, this is where the very loose, but this is where the suction is at, basically. I'm not gonna really edit this video, so hopefully. Put the bag back on. Pause. There we go, it's back on. What I was trying to get at is this is the filter down there. Same as this. And with a little bit of there. Back, it's back in place. Now, that back. Oops. Dang it. This piece, I believe, goes back down into there, and for the most part, I can't do this one-handed. Alright, that only took about 10 seconds at most to put back in. That flat piece goes in there. The other end goes in here. Then put that back in here. Go down in there. And then, yeah. That's pretty much about it. Let's see what this actually says. Retailer. Manufactured in the USA. Awesome. Global source components. Alright, so there's your serial number in case you're looking at this video and you want to look it up. Thermal reset.
Unplug machine, locate problem source, clogged hose, or full bag. Most of the time, this is going to be a clogged hose. If I do this correctly in vacuum rooms every day, the majority of the time, it takes me about a decent week to fill the bag up. If that's with heavy use, but I vacuumed up small rocks, salt for the winter time, because as of right now it is winter and they put salt all over for the schools. It sucks up and cleans those entryways with no problem at all. It cleans up carpets, any floor surface, really. This vacuum can honestly be used on this surface, that surface, and the carpet. You can do all of them at the same time, or whatever your preference is, or whatever is allowed wherever you're at. But this vacuum is meant and is built to take abuse. That doesn't mean piss off your employer and scuff up a brand new vacuum, because obviously this has been run against quite a few walls like these, the edges. Again, if you're going to be abusing your vacuum, not like a dirt devil or any of those other expensive vacuums, I believe these run roughly $300 to $400 a piece, which I would not hesitate to buy one myself for at home use. Especially if you have animals, this will suck up that hair. There is just so much more to this vacuum than what I can explain, but if you're looking for a professional grade vacuum, I would choose RICCAR, however you want to pronounce it, but it's RICCAR. This is not a paid video, although it'd be nice if it was, because that would be the extra income, but hey, this is my own personal review. Now, if you're wondering about this attachment, I honestly don't know where they come from. I just know that you can get them somewhere. Don't know where, but the schools apparently have them on standby. But instead of twisting these in a knot so that they won't come apart, these are meant to hold, obviously, both of these together, and when you yank on it, it won't come apart, or at least it shouldn't come apart, because I have been able to accidentally break these. And it looks like it's pretty secure, so unless I do something stupid with it, that's gonna stay there. Any questions or comments or concerns or anything like that, let me know. But this is my favorite vacuum. Again, it's a RICCAR vacuum. Having a good day. Thank you.
Thank you.
when I got to the entry exit, well, it says not an exit, but teacher used it at the end of the day. I go slow on these to get all the salt out. And I don't know if you could hear it or not, but the reason I was going extremely slow in there was because it was picking up all that sand, all the dirt, the little rocks in between all those little cracks. Like I said, a lot of abuse.